Now let us study about the types of silk. There are different types of silk. The most common type is the mulberry silk. Okay. The most common type of silk is the mulberry silk. Mulberry silk worm. The mulberry silkworm is known as the Bombyx mori. The scientific name is Bombyx mori. Bombyx mori is the mulberry silk which feed on the mulberry leaves. This particular mulberry silkworms are the mostly cultivated silkworm in the world. About 90% of the silk production is from mulberry silkworm. Okay, and its scientific name is Bombyx mori. It eats the mulberry leaves, the Morus alba plant. And the second one is the tussar silk. Second type is tussar silk. And the third type is Muga silk. Muga. Third type is Muga silk. And the fourth one is Eri silk. Okay. Eri silk. So these are the four types of silk. Mulberry silk, Tussar silk, Muga silk and Eri silk. Out of which mulberry silk is the most common type of silk, and 90% of the silk production is from mulberry silkworm, and its scientific name is Bombyx mori. So the mulberry silk is actually very flexible, very shiny, elastic and strong silk. Okay, mulberry silk is very strong, the fibers are very strong, the fibers are elastic, the fibers are shiny. And another property is that it can be dyed into various colors. Therefore, mulberry silk is very commercially very, very important silk, which is used most of the people. Tussar silk in China and all, more production is of tussar silk. Okay, tussar silk. Tussar silk comes under a genus called Andrei. Andrei. Okay. That even in India that silk is there, but the most common type of silk is the mulberry silk. Now let us see the rearing and processing of silk. Actually, the female silk moth lay hundreds of eggs at a time. The farmers collect these eggs and they keep in their home under suitable humidity and suitable temperature. When the mulberry plants grow and produce fresh leaves, during that time the farmers give suitable temperature to the eggs they collected, so that the larva, the silkworm larva, caterpillars are come out. So caterpillars are actually developed or induced, the eggs are induced to produce silkworm at the time of fresh leaf formation of mulberry plants, because mulberry leaves are needed for the growth of the caterpillars. Once the larva came out, they will keep this larva in bamboo trays. Okay, in bamboo trays with sufficient amount of chopped mulberry leaves. That means they keep mulberry leaves along with the caterpillars, along with the larva. The larvae eat this mulberry leaves day and night, and they enormously increase in their size. After 25 to 30 days, they sufficiently eat and grow in size, and after that they stop eating. And it is the time of the fiber formation, the saliva secretion. At that time, small twigs or trays are kept, or small twigs or some straw are kept along with the bamboo trays, so that the grown, the fully grown caterpillars go and attach them. Once they attach to the twigs or the tray, they started secreting the saliva, that fiber. When the saliva, the liquid come out, it become hardened to form fibers, and the fibers are get entangled to form cocoons. Okay. Now these cocoons are actually taken by the farmers, because they get the silk fibers from the cocoon stage, and they will process it. How they will process it? See, they will put these cocoons, the collected pile of cocoons, they either put in boiling water or they will keep in sunlight. When they keep the cocoons, pile of cocoons, in boiling water or sunlight, the silk are separated. It means the cocoon and the worms are get separated. Once the silk fibers are separated, the silk fibers are separated from the cocoon with the help of some machine. This process of separating silk fibers from the cocoon is known as reeling of silk. Reeling of silk. Okay. What do you mean by reeling of silk? The process of separation of silk fibers from the cocoons is known as reeling of silk, which is done by special reeling machines. So once these silk fibers are separated from the cocoon, these silk fibers are joined and big yarns, big threads are formed, produced, and these yarns are woven into or maybe colored. Okay, these yarns are dyed into different colors, and finally they are woven into beautiful silk fabrics. Are you clear? So how they are reared? They collected from the, what you call, sericulture unit. The farmers collect the eggs, and eggs are kept under suitable moisture, humidity and temperature. Once the mulberry plants produce sufficient amount of fresh leaves, the farmers give suitable temperature to the eggs so that the larva come out, and the larva are kept in bamboo trays along with the chopped fresh mulberry leaves. The larva eat day and night and increase enormously in its size, and after 25 to 30 days it will stop eating. At that time, some twigs or straw are kept in the bamboo trays, where this larva go and attach and start producing the fiber. And it produce sufficient fibers and get entangled itself to form cocoon. At the stage of cocoons, the farmers collect the cocoons for processing. Okay, what are the steps involved in processing? The cocoons are collected, they are kept, pile of cocoons are either put inside boiling water or kept under sunlight, so that the worms and cocoons are separated first. Now this cocoon along with the fibers are selected, and the silk fibers are separated from the cocoons. This process is known as reeling of silk. The process of separation of silk fibers from the separated cocoons is known as reeling of silk. This reeling is done by special reeling machines. Once the silk are separated and collected, they are made into very long yarns. These yarns are dyed into different colors, and they are woven into beautiful silk fabrics.